This video covers the use of substrated grids for TEM. I'm using 200 mesh copper grids. They come in nickel and gold and meshes from 150 to 1500, but I'm going to be using these 200 mesh grids. First thing to do is to determine which side the substrate is on. Our substrates are all on the shiny or brassy side. And then there's the coppery side, which is that one. The brass side is a little shinier and darker. So all of ours are on the brassy side, not the copper side. Looking at the back of the grid on a dissecting microscope, we can see a thickness to the bars with the substrate on the other side. So this is the non-substrated side, and we can see that there's texture. It's not all smooth. Which it would be the substrated side. Substrated grids are generally pretty hydrophobic, and so what we're going to do is a glow discharge to 20 milliamps for a couple minutes to make the surface more hydrophilic for picking up sections and or you're depositing an aqueous based particles. So I'm going to pick up some sections on my freshly glow discharged substrated grid, and we can see that the water is not repelled. The grid wets pretty evenly, and when I go to pick up sections, they don't run away. Sometimes if you have a very hydrophobic grid, then the sections, it's hard to get those on your grid. And of course you always want to collect more than one. And if we take a look at it, we can see our sections on there, and we're ready to do work.